long time ago, on a very peculiar day, my mirror lured someone out of his bed.
Okay, then.
And opened a doorway to my workshop. I do not know if the mirror was being mischievous or malicious.
Probably both. Yeah, that's weird, the reverse.
Perhaps it knew that the curious intruder had a role to play in my project.
Shouldn't have done that. Master Yen Sid.
Finishing touches on my latest creation. A world for things that have been forgotten.
Ooh. Oh, that's so cool. All the detailing of his beard. But the hair in general, it's like, that's really good.
Satisfied with my progress, I put the magic brush down and retired to my chambers. Had I known what events would follow, I would have locked away everything. Paint, brush, and thinner.
Yeah, probably a good idea. Dude. Of course, be like, I wasn't here. I was never here. I was never here at all.
I heard the noises and rushed to see what had happened. But I was too late. The world I had created was ravaged. A wasteland.
Wasteland.
The mysterious intruder was gone. I did not learn his identity. Well, not for a very long time.
Going through with all the cartoons. Sharing his success of like, yay, I'm the greatest, I'm the best, I'm the best. Until one day, a monster entered his room and attacked him. That's pretty much how to sum this up. He's like, oh no! Oh! Well, there he goes. Oh, bother. Dead. Well, that was quite the intro. Hey, what's up, you guys? My name is Superstar Wolf, and welcome to Epic Mickey Rebrush, specifically the demo of this game. This is something that I've been debating on whether or not to give it a shot. As sort of like the next Let's Play series. And I saw that there was a demo available for this, so this is a nice opportunity. It's gonna give me a chance to play this game, really get a feel for it, and see what it's like. So, let's go ahead and get started. So I've never played Epic Mickey before. Like, I've seen videos of it, and I'm somewhat familiar with it, but in general, I've never fully seen this game. The Mad Doctor. Oswald. Okay, so what's going on? Hello. We got scissors? Drill? It's like, no! Chainsaw? Like, no! Death. A plunger? How is a plunger death? That makes no sense. Of course, he's like, yeah, fuck you. It's like fighting in the Heartless. I'm armed with a paintbrush. I'm not afraid to use it. Eh? It's like, bye. Oswald. Hello. Oops. No bother. Yeah, literally any of those tools would have been more effective than the toilet plunger. Oh, we're finally getting into the gate. Over here, you bucket of bolts! Ah, so that's Gus. Missed me! That's cool, I love the Disney villain portraits. Over here, Mickey! Okay, so keep going in. Can we get started? Ooh, new quest. Yay! Okay, I'm in. Okay, so X jump. Whoa, that's weird. There's like splashes of ink like dripping off of me. Like, what is that? It looks weird. So as I said, like, I never played this game before. Like, I knew about it about a really long time ago, but from what I've heard, this is, like, one of the darker, like, one of the darker Disney-style games. Which is very shocking, especially since it's revolving around Mickey Mouse. We're safe on this spot, Mickey. This controller panel can be damaged with your spin move. Use your spin move. Right, I figured that out by pressing square. When that control panel is broken, take care of this one. Okay, pretty simple enough. Okay, right, for jump. Figure that out. So, whoop! Yeah! Yes. Okay, here we go. And now, whoop! Can I? Okay, no, I can't destroy that. Okay, go. There we go! Nah, perfect, he's dead. Look, the mechanical arms destruction revealed a secret room. You may take a moment to explore it if you'd like. When you're ready, come to me. We'll get out of here. Okay, so looks like now we're safe. But yeah, this really looked interesting. Like, I do remember seeing, I think, like, some trailers of it years ago, because this originally came out for the Wii. Or maybe it was for the Wii U. No, it was for the... For Epic Mickey... Epic Mickey with Oswald. Oswald, like the multiplayer sequel game that they did. What do we got? Mad Doctor's Lab. I do remember seeing the Mad Doctor was for, like, a really old... Mickey Mouse cartoon. What's in a chest? Ooh. a bronze pin. Here! Well done! This is a collectible pin, one of many that you may find in Wasteland. Most of them are unique and commemorate specific events or places. You should see how many you could collect while you're here. Okay. But I do remember seeing of, like, some of the stuff here. Like, I'm somewhat familiar with the story. The idea is that, like, we're in this world that was created for cartoon characters that were forgotten. Be careful with that thinner pool. Remember that energy so don't fall in. Okay. Right, the thinner. Okay. But as I said, like, I'm somewhat familiar with the story, but not too much of it, though. But I was very interested in this game, especially, like, since we've gotten lack of Kingdom Hearts as of late. And this honestly would look like an interesting Kingdom Hearts world. I think I've said it before, but it would be kind of interesting if they did introduce, like, Oswald the Lucky Rabbit in Kingdom Hearts, as I could see him being either as I have him here, connected to Mickey to some way, the way we go to Wasteland, or even have Oswald be, like, Mickey's nobody. Nobody, which I think would be sort of, like, an interesting approach. Oh, man, those are really cool portraits. So we got Scar, Maleficent, and Captain Hook. Some of the most iconic villains. We got Oswald. Looks like if this was Kingdom Hearts, he'd basically be, like, Mickey of this world. As well, he's the king. Okay, can I make it? Fuck. I have to get back home. I got pulled into this place by that ink monster. The Shadow Blot. It's a thing made of paint and thinner. That, blot seemed awfully weird it is. Wow! That's thinner. It dissolves anything painted. Gosh, I wonder what else this brush can do. That's paint. It restores anything dissolved by thinner. You're quite the artist. Okay, how do you explain this? Well, you're just full of surprises. I guess you soaked up some of the blot? Okay, is that a good thing or a bad thing? But I'm still me! Let's practice! I can't really do, like, a full Mickey Mouse. So hold L2 to use dinner, hold R2 to use paint. Okay. Thank you for the heart. Dinner. Ooh. Okay, so that's how that works. At the end of the corridor, the dockyard, take us to the Dark Beauty Castle. Ooh, can we go back? Because I saw that there was some stuff. Don't worry. Alright, I will always be around when you need help. Okay, but can we go back? Because I saw that there were sections that we could interact with. Maybe we could probably go back, like, in the actual game. Okay. Here. Okay, so it looks like I have about 3 uses in total of this. I like how we can kind of restore, like, different sections of each. Looks really cool. Oh, and that was awesome. There was just a little effect sip. As of, like, seeing stuff. I like seeing the stuff restored. It's pretty cool. Nice. Point that thinner at the gear. I will. But first, I'm looking for secrets. Gotta find the lore. Nice. This is pretty good so far. Like, it would definitely be interesting if there was a Kingdom Hearts as worlds. I don't know if they would incorporate this into KH4. This would be interesting, though, especially if in Kingdom Hearts 4, they're going to explore... You can brush through cartoon objects like a door frame. Okay. It would be interesting if they do explore more into that. Since they're talking about, it looks like going to be exploring more parallel worlds. I could see them, creating a parallel world. Like, another version for Oswald would be, like, a parallel version of Mickey. That would be interesting. Anything here? Nope. Okay, I can just get that. Store. Nice. Okay, this is a war. So far, pretty explanatory. Looks like you could use dinner on the floor. Okay, we'll do first. Thank you. Nice. Anything here? Nope. Nice, nice, nice. Ooh! Don't forget that the thin tuned can be restored. Right. Of course. Ooh. Yeah, I'm assuming that I'm collecting, like, tokens that I can use to, like, buy upgrades. Hi, Oswald! Okay, well, that's rude. Hello! Hello! The exit through this gate. Okay. What is that? Uh-oh! Uh-oh. Yeah. Zia's part of the Blot's blotting army! Are they dangerous? Well, they're not good company. Get ready to fight. Key R to aim at the target, okay. Alfred and his cousin look like... opponents look like this. Okay, so... pretty good. You'll fight Blotlings in two ways. Hit them with thinner to thin them out. And then with paint to turn them friendly. Interesting. Many opponents are stunned. You can jump on their heads. Each time an opponent hits you, you lose his health bar. Okay. Okay, so pretty explanatory. The Seers are only one type of blotting. Other kinds of blotting are worse, but you're seasoned enough. I kind of like the switching between like actual gameplay and then and then like this interesting art style. And it looks like some stuff, especially with the lots of these things, is mostly just used for effect. Okay. Do that. Get some more. Thank you. Look out! That's your soul, you Mickey. Looks like a cold for a friend. Okay, so I turn to friendly. Whoa! If I do it like this... interesting. So now is it now... okay, so I guess now it's not gonna attack us. Okay, that's interesting. I mostly just wanted to see, like, the difference between the two. Oh, that's also interesting. Like, you can't fully see it because of my logo, but... oh, but it looks like if I'm low on paint or thinner, and it at least replenishes at least one... one small container for it. I guess that makes sense. Like if you're in a jam. Nice. Nice. Whoa. Cool. Okay. So far, this is pretty. It's pretty good. Pretty good. Is there no more gonna come out? Do that. Nope. Okay. Yup. Some more. Man, the detailing of this, I definitely do remember I never played this game, but I did see, like, some of the videos talking about it, and, like, just some of the gameplay aspects of it, like, they really they really went through the whole remastering. Castle entrance. Cool, cool, cool. Nice. Cool. Okay, so how do we... ooh. What? Oh. This pressure plate, it would lower you if you step on it. You could also make pressure plates go down faster. Up in the air. Okay. Oh. So it's basically just a ground slam. Usual spin move on the scare to interact with it. Remember, you can press square to perform the spin attack. I know. Marvelous! That's Gremlin Calvin! He'll be happy to get out of that cage. He looks bad enough to break that catapult. When you see other gremlins, try to help them. They're sure to be friends. Calvin! Hello? Careful, Mickey. I'm just sitting on the pressure plate. It will fire that catapult if it's disturbed. Do you really want to choose a treasure chest just over the safety of a gremlin? Well, can't I just... well, okay. So... wait, can't I just use this guy to... and say, hey, buddy, sir, can you go over there and step on the pressure plate, please? No, I guess not. Damn it. There you go! Calvin! Thank you, Mickey. I feared the worst when the mad doctor put me in this thing. Now won't endanger anyone else. Take this gold pin for freeing me. A gold pin? What? Oh, what about the chassis? Damn it. Ooh, here we go. Although I guess it would have just given me, like, more of these things that I can't really use. Okay, so now what? Hello? Use dinner to remove. Okay, oh. Nice. That's a good way of, like, finding secrets. It is pretty satisfying of, like, seeing all the stuff, like, first get blasted away, and then, like, you can choose to restore it. Okay, that. Nice. Pretty sure that would just leave me down. Am I right? Yeah. Dead end. Okay. Well, good to double check. Let's see here. Sweet. Sweet. Audrey camera. Okay. Oh, interesting. Okay, so it just helps you center, like, whatever direction Mickey's facing. There we go. Nice. Okay, that's one. Hello! I like it. I like that. Okay, you knock the gear loose to get it opening. Here at Wasteland, you'll find that gears and machines make all kinds of things happen. Repairing and starting them, and it will often reveal secrets and treasures. Cool, cool. Yes! Towers. Okay, so there is a distance of, like, how much fall damage you can take. That. I'm just going around, like, repairing stuff. Because, like I said, it's weirdly satisfying of with some of the stuff. You run faster. Okay, that'll definitely. Whoops. That'll definitely come in handy. Okay, anything more? Yeah, just fix this. Alright, we're good. Bye! It is cool how they've implemented for some of the stuff, like, it interacts. It interacts with the environment. Nice. And it does make sense that with some of the stuff, it looks very much out of place. But I guess it's like an easier way for players to see if, like, okay, which stuff do we use the pay attention on? Sega gear down and a projector screen. That's our way out of the castle. Let's go and take a closer look. Mickey and the Beanstalk. I'm assuming that a lot of these are going to be references to. Ow. A lot of these are going to be references to, like, some of the classic Mickey cartoons that they did. Walt Disney presented by Mickey Mouse. Are you ready to enter the projector screen? Yes. That rabbit went this way, but portals like this are how we get around. That rabbit named Oswald, he set them up. But a projector screen? What's so strange? It seems natural for cartoons. Well, what's in there? Just get ready to jump. Okay. Whoa! It's a little 2D effect. Interesting. Escape of the castle. Okay, got that. Oh, interesting. So, I just tried to use it, but I can't use it. I use my paintbrush here. Oh, that's so weird. It's like we're in a reel of film projector. Like we're in a projector film reel. Okay. Okay, I had another double jump. Ooh. Ooh, that was good. Ooh. How do I? Damn it! Okay, I gotta get out there. Come on. Fuck. Can I go down in here? Get it? Yeah! Alright, Mickey and the Beanstalk. Perfect. Man, this is pretty cool. Gonna make it! Yes! Let's see. Yeah, that's so weird. I guess they really emphasize. I really like sort of shown. Okay, I guess I just ride this then. I guess it like really shows that this is like part of the cartoons. And it's almost like a meta kind of way of like how Mickey's adventure is going into this. Is there a film? I wonder if those are gonna be like concept arts of like the classic cartoons they did. Would you like to travel to Slalom? Yes. Get me out of here. Man, the art style is really... Again, like I said, like this art style is kind of creepy. Okay. It's Gremlin Taisto. What are you doing here? I guess someone sabotaged this door. It's gonna take paint to fix it. That's an impressive door. Definitely Gremlin construction. Hey, Mickey, can you throw paint around? Why not? I'll paint those gears for Taisto. That'd be great. I've been working on the middle gear. But it won't move. Okay. You first get some of this stuff. But yeah, it's almost like a meta kind of game for like it shows the behind the scenes of like some of the Mickey Mouse cartoons. Hooray! You fixed it! Oh no, did you see that? That nasty thing related to those ears is back. That pipe section is thinned out. Think steam escape? Don't touch the steam, it'll knock you back. Now please patch those pipes when you see them. Thank you for your help. Only someone with your unique talent for creating paint could have done it. It's I'll meet you further down the line. I'm sure of it. Patch the pipes. Okay. Yep. We did that. it's just a bunch of duct tape around with the pipes. Yeah. I guess that works for... especially for a cartoon world. There it is again. You should be able to go that way too. But watch your step. No problem. With the power of paint, I can repair the way. It's also kind of cool how they divide it up into sections. Sections for like their specific parts where you wouldn't need to fully paint or thin out everything. It just takes up like, just go for like one section at a time. And it comes in handy, especially of like, to conserving certain paint and thinner. There we go. And this. Well done! Okay, so we have, two more to go. Wait, is there anything here? Whoa! That's so cool! Oh. Nice little secrets. Secrets. Lore. Okay, more paints, thank you. I hope I can upgrade. Like, when the actual game comes out, I'll be able to upgrade my paints, so... my paint and thinner, so I have, like, more supplies. Okay, alright, that's all the patches. I should be able to... Watch your step! Try double jumping to reach platform. Okay, yep. Forget about the double jump. Oh, wait, there's more stuff down here. Nice. Oh, go. Can I make it? Yes! Okay, can I make it back? Yes! Barely made it. No. Double jump helps when you're ready for the right moment. Just double jump. Okay, restore that. Damn it. Missed the timing. Okay, there we go. Yeah. This is cool. This is cool, though. Like, it's definitely... as someone who's never played the original Epic Mickey, this is gonna be, like, a new experience. It's like, man, this is awesome. Actually pretty cool. Pretty cool. Like, I... Man, there's gotta be a way to get there. Wait! You're not supposed to see a... Oh dear, a trap! It is a trap! Someone shut the door, and now splatter... There you go. As I thought, splatters are... There's a rarity solitary creature. Hey, you splatters, beat it! Yeah, I'll make it, we'll give you what for. Well, now, there's a problem with the exit with the doors being closed. I think it just teleport and then, like, just beat it with a wrench. Here, let me clear a path for the collectible you enjoy. Hold on now! That's Oswald! Could he have set this trap? Well, that's rather rude. Whoa! Yeah, Seer and Splatter. Interesting. Interesting. Well, they're definitely... well, these guys definitely so far aren't tougher than Heartless. Like the regular Heartless. But I'll probably, like, later on down the line see much tougher and stronger opponents. Alright, so where to next? Whoa. What is that? Oh my, you attracted a guardian, Mickey. The guardians you attract can help you in several ways. Press R1 and the guardians will race to the nearest opponent. Interesting. But wait, there's more. No! Hold R1 to launch all of your guardians. Okay, so I can gain more. Charms will unleash thinner, and tints will do the same thing with paint. Interesting. A guardian used in either of these ways will disappear. It's so grim. Looks like Gremlin Tim is trapped in the ticket booth. Tim! Hey, you over there, help me! Deal with these creatures and how are you trapped here? Hello! Ow! Ow, fuck you! Oh, that's interesting. So, ow. Okay, so it looks like whichever one that I use the most, I create a guardian more of. Fascinating. All right, Spanish, just because Mickey went easy on you doesn't mean I will. Beat it. I'll start those boots. Let's forget now. So rude. Yeah, the guardians you attract will help you in several ways. Always. You can attract more by painting or thinning the world. Okay, so that's what I figured. There, a bar on top of the left will show your progress of attracting guardians. Each segment of the bar completely attracts a new guardian. Guardians exist to help you, Mickey. Why is anyone's guess? I like how when he gives the tutorial instructions, he puts on, like, the little, like, teacher student cap and then just goes in for it. Hello. Thank you for taking care of the blotlings. If you have time... there are rides I need your help, Mickey. I'd love to start with a ride, but it seems the machinery is broken. I need my wrench. I was working on a spinning cup with a red stripe on top of it when a splatter is attached. I haven't seen it since. If you're willing to help, come see me near the machine behind the elephant ride. Interesting. Okay, ticket booth. I guess these are, like, kind of side quests that we can do. Yeah, sure. Sure. I don't know really, like... Okay, how long is this demo? Demo, but I'm assuming that it's just gonna give you, like, the basic stuff here. Okay, just to see, is there anything here? Nope. Here we go. But yeah, you gotta see my bar is, like, filling up as it goes. Oh, man. Oh, man, my OCD brain is like, it's very much incomplete. Very much incomplete. Whoop! See, is there anything here? Nope. Yeah, but it's very grim. Which I guess is the point of this game. Like I said, this is supposed to be, like, one of the dark... it's surprisingly a darker game, especially since it has Mickey Mouse. Keycup ride. There we go. Oh, God. Okay, is this it? Ah, yeah, you found a wrench. Okay, perfect. That's definitely a gremlin wrench. Oh, God. Here, nope. That's very interesting. Nice. You. I do like how you can interact with some of the stuff. In fact, I think, it's been a really long time since I have checked, like, some of those videos of this game. But I think the ending of this game is tied into, like, how much you destroy and how much you restore. Like, this game really centers around, like, destroying and restoring Wasteland. There's something up there. Oh, I already got it. Go. It's also a cool way, like, back when they made this game, to introduce modern audiences to, like, some of their really old characters. I think it's really cool. All right. Oh, so what we got? And of course, we got like some of the more breakable stuff. It's, I like the little satisfying sounds it makes. Okay. But yeah, this whole thing is grim. Like, I guess this is a result of Mickey creating the plots. Like, it really destroys Wasteland. Wasteland, as they're calling it. The Wasteland. Wasteland. I'm assuming that it was supposed to have a different name. My wrench! Now I can fix the broken elephant ride machine. Okay. Is that Dumbo? The spinning cup ride is malfunctioning as well. Looks like the pipes behind the maintenance area are leaking. Alright, non-flying types. Non-types like you can use the elephant ride to jump into the big tent. Or now you can reach the maintenance area. Okay. It's a difficult path, but you seem to be capable. If you need me, I will be behind the spinning cup ride and examining the machine. Okay. Ticket booth. Interesting. Wait. What I want to do again. Yes. I'm sure it'll explain more of, like, the currency. Like, how each of these things are. But I'm assuming that, like, each of them have, like, a set worth of, like, how many points there are. Like, maybe blue or green's, like, the most expensive, and red's, like, kind of the cheapest, as it's, like, the most common. Here we go. Yeah. Well, I guess if I... Nice. But yeah, are these really supposed to be, like, Dumbo? Man, that's very grim. It's also interesting that they're referencing other Disney characters, like, not just Mickey Mouse-related characters, but, like, a variety of Disney characters. Which I think Wasteland, that's what Wasteland is supposed to be. It's supposed to be a world dedicated to, like, the Forgotten Toons. If I remember right. Interesting. What? Oh, man. Why, that's really gonna mess me up. Like, just doing, like, some of these smaller stuff here. Yeah, why have these in separate components? Why not just make it a singular thing? Go ahead and restore this. This. I wonder if maybe, like, these patches, like, these more colorful ones, that's originally what this section of Wasteland is supposed to be. But the destroyed stuff, represents of, like, the world is now basically broken. Hello, sir. There's Gears. It's, okay. So stop them. Okay, wait. And then... Now? Nice. Oh, God. Go ahead and do that. That's really cool. Whoa. Why is part of that purple? Is it like a combo or something? That. Sweet. Okay. I'll come back and get that little bit. Especially since. Oh, God. Okay, restore. It is a good thing that they do at least restore the last pink container. Because I can definitely see a situation for, like. You know, like, say you're using one thing too much and you need to use one of the other ones, but you don't have. Like, enough, supplies to do the other thing, so it's kind of like, oh, God. Okay, what have I got? This is a paint and thinner pump, standard equipment for most rides. It can be filled with either paint or thinner, but never both at the same time. Paint often fixes things, gets the ride running smoother. Thinner, and it tends to throw a wrench in the works. Sometimes that's handy, though. A paint and thinner pump is always connected to something. This one connected to the spinning cup ride is, in this case, connected to the pipes. To repair the ride, patch the pipes and fill the pump. Remember, though, filling it with thinner and me, they have unexpected consequences. I do like how they kind of put it in for either or. It'll, like, the pipe's not fixed, now fill up the pump. We want to get the ride smoothly again, so let's fill it up with paint. There you go. But it kind of, like, represents, Tim, you fixed the ride. Alright, so if that's so much better, now that I can open this door for you, please keep whatever you may find in there, along with my gratitude. Yes. So maybe, like, restoring stuff will, like, help you give better rewards or something? Yeah, because I can see that. store. There we go. Cool. And yeah, because now everything is now running much smoothly. I wonder if these cups were all supposed to look the same. Like, I'm really thinking that the more colorful ones, colorful and repaired ones, those represent of, like, what Wasteland is supposed to look like. And then, like, the destroyed, grim-looking versions, those represent of, like, basically, I guess, like, the consequences of what happens to this world. Well, because of the blot. But it is making me think of, like, Bendy in Ink Machine. Ink Machine. What the? Oh, Walt Disney News. Mickey Mouse. Yes. Well, I guess even Mickey... I'm kind of surprised it doesn't say, like, Oswald, because I think Oswald's supposed to be the Mickey of this world. Silver pin. Is there a difference between, like, the colored pins? I'm assuming. Like, maybe they give you higher rewards or something? Like, these little, little tickets I'm finding. Okay, I'm not sure why this is saying, I'm like... Probably because of this thing. Because, yeah, otherwise it's like... Okay, yeah, it doesn't affect this. Okay, that was sword. I saw that there was something in here, so... Do that. Go here. Ooh, some more breakables. Nice. Here we go. Whoop! Nice. It's interesting that they don't give dialogue into this. Like, maybe this represents of, like, the classic Mickey cartoons for, like, Mickey never really talked. Well, none of the characters really talked. Not, like, because it was back in the olden days. On this before... of, like, just drawing cartoons before... Whoa, God! Glitched. Oh dear. Well, this ride isn't fixed at all. Look at the boat. Look at these boats jammed here. Some are even overturned. That door should have automatically opened, but I guess it's broken too. There are pipes inside the walls. Once that operate the door's locks, thinning out those pipes will break, made the locks and the door should open. Now that I think of it, the hippos are connected to the door as well. Stopping the hippos with paint, and it will bypass the door's locks, and that will open too. So it goes back to, like, you could use either paint or thinner. Also, I love the little animation bit for where, like, no matter where I look, my mouse ears are, like, constantly facing the audience. Here we go. It's like a nice little attention to detail. Though it must have taken forever to, like, properly get that. That. There's something up there. Oh, but can I even make it that far? Oh, just barely. Okay. Ah, that was stupid. I should have done a double jump. It's fine, though. Perfect. Get that out. Cool. Okay, just wanted to... get, like, some of the stuff. Ow, fuck! A heart, thank you! Ooh, a heart just restores everything. Okay, so, it's not, like, one at a time. Okay, that's good, that's good. And just get one more of this. Nope. Man, imagine if I had the Keyblade. You're like a key... Like, ooh, there should be a mod of, like, a Keyblade paintbrush. Or, like, replace the paintbrush with Mickey's Keyblade. So that way, and do, like, a light and dark magic. Like, the light representing the paint, and then the dark representing, like, the thinner. That'd be pretty cool. Pretty cool combination. Ah, thanks for playing. I guess that's the end of that. Okay, so I guess that's gonna do it for this episode of Epic Mickey Rebrushed here. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. This is actually a pretty fun game, so I think I might go ahead and do this for, like, the next Let's Play series. Like, it's a pretty unique game. I like how it's sort of like a more grim tone, but it does have, like, some of the lightheartedness here and there. here and there. There's probably a lot more stuff like that in the game. And I do like how, back with the environments, I'm pretty sure the more colorful patches, those represent of, like, what the world is supposed to look like. And I like how you can switch it between using paint to restore or using thinner to blast it away. It's a really cool effect of detailing everything. So that's definitely interesting. Really interesting. And like I said before, I'm not super familiar with everything about this. Like, I've seen some of the gameplay before, but this would be like a whole new experience for me. So I think this would be a fun game to like give a shot for a series, and a nice sort of series to wait in for, like Kingdom Hearts 4, because we still haven't gotten any more news about it yet. I'm hoping we get something soon, at least like another progress trailer, just to like show the game is still being worked on, and they are making good progress into it. For now, though, I think that's gonna be it. Anyway, I'm gonna go ahead and get back to work on like some of the minifigures. I am making great progress in my current minifigures with the symbiote surge suit, and I started a little bit on a new Doomslayer minifigure. So hopefully that turns out great. And for now, that's gonna be it. So if you guys want to see more videos like this in the future, be sure to subscribe to the channel and hit the bell for notifications. It really helps us with likes, Lego products, and for now, it's so fun. So overall, thank you guys so much for watching this video. If you liked it, hit that like button, comment, and share to friends. Subscribe to YouTube, follow me on Twitch. Thank you all so much for watching. I'll see you all next time in the next video. Goodbye.